And dinada on David's answer. And yes, I have that motion right in front of me, although I shorthanded it. Bob printed the whole thing. I just printed the first two pages, okay? Thank you, Bob Bianchi and Brian Buckmeyer, who brought this to our attention earlier today. But there's also a section of the law that says if the offense was committed in the presence of a child. Now, yesterday we heard from, let me count them. 1, 2, 3, 4 minors at least, okay? Darnella, who took the video. We heard from Alyssa. We heard from Judea. And we heard from Kaylin. Is the reason why the prosecution called all four of these minors because of that?
Well, that was definitely, I think, why they called the youngest of the minors, because she didn't have that much more to contribute and maybe wouldn't necessarily have put somebody so young on the stand otherwise. The first one, though, she actually took the video, so that was very important to hear from her. But yes, they need this enhancement to show he did it in the presence of a minor, and they did that by calling them.
Okay. Okay. Dina Dahl. We had yesterday a special guest on this program, James Cook. He is a civil rights lawyer. Hi, James, if you're listening, I hope you are. He is also an MMA fighter. He is a Thai boxing champion, and he also is a member of Donald Williams' gym. So we asked him, James, is Donald Williams an expert in this whole blood choke and what is it? And he said yes. So could you tell us now that you're a member of the jury, what is the blood choke that Mr. Williams is speaking of?
Well, essentially, it's a choke that's going to not only render somebody unconscious, but kill them. Like, as he described it, it cuts off their blood circulation to his head. And I just think it's amazing that there was three witnesses to this, all kind of having some sort of expertise that watched this and were alarmed by it. The 911 dispatcher, who had expertise in emergency training, this MMA fighter who had expertise in the chokehold, the EMT who had expertise. We see so many crimes here on Law and Crime, and often we don't even ever get a chance to see video of it. But to have three witnesses have experience that led to actually the act that happened and to testify, that is shockingly strong for the prosecution. We don't see that very often.